Welcome again. Right now we're at 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verses 1 through 8. Have you ever heard anybody say, well, you know, who am I to judge? Or, you know, God is judge. I'm not here to judge. God is the judge. Let's see what the scriptures say about this. Dare any of you, having a matter against his neighbor, go to law before the unrighteous and not before the saints? Paul is very upset here with some of the people in Corinth because they had matters. They had disputes against one another. These are the believers, okay? They had disputes against one another, and they went before the secular courts. They went before the unrighteous to have their issues, their cases judged. Paul here is saying, listen, dare you go before the unrighteous and not before the saints? Don't you know that the saints will judge the world? And if the world is judged by you, are you unworthy to judge the smallest matters? Don't you know that we will judge angels? How much more things that pertain to this life? Paul here is shaming them. He's saying, listen, you know, every Christian, every one of you, your job in the future is to judge angels. And you can't judge just between one another, just trivial things. If then you have to judge things pertaining to this life, do you set them to judge who are of no account in the assembly? Those who are not even part of the assembly, those who are believers, like, you are setting, you know, unbelieving judges over you? Verse 5, Paul says, I say this to move you to shame. Isn't there even one wise man among you who would be able to decide between his brothers? But brother goes to law with brother, and that before unbelievers? Therefore, it is already altogether a defect in you that you have lawsuits with one another. Why not rather be wronged? Why not rather be defrauded? No, but you yourselves do wrong and defraud, and that against your brothers. As I said in the beginning, a lot of people says, well, who am I to judge? And they say, well, God is judge. I'm not here to judge. I can't judge you. God is our judge. That is completely wrong. That is completely incorrect. If you are a true believer, and if you are a true Christian, if you have truly been born again, your job, you have it slotted in for you in the future. God has given you the job to judge the world. And not only that, but the angels too. What do you mean, who are you to judge? God says that your job is to judge the world. And not only that, but the angels themselves. Listen, if you can't judge one another, if you can't judge one another here on earth, okay? Who am I to judge? Judge not. Again, how many times do we have to say this? Jesus said, judge not, to the hypocrites, because he says, in the matters that you judge other people, you will be judged in those matters. Why? Because you do the same things you condemn other people for doing, okay? So that's it. Jesus was talking to hypocrites. He wasn't talking to his disciples. He wasn't talking to the believers. He was talking to the hypocrites. He says, don't judge, because you are going to be judged because you're a hypocrite. You condemn other people for the same thing that you are doing. Now, I say that because there is a big difference between condemning other people for the same thing that you are doing as compared to condemning other people for the same things that you used to do. You see, when you repent, that is when the slate is wiped clean. That's clear all the way through Scripture. When you repent, the old is not held against you. So stop saying, well, it's God's job to judge. God's saying the same thing about you. He's saying, listen, it's your job to judge. That's what he says right here. Can you imagine now? Just picture this. Every true Christian given a court or given time in court to sit on the bench to be a judge, and the world, the whole world, one by one by one, will come before you, and you will judge them. And the angels themselves will come before you one by one by one, and you will judge them. What power the Christian has. Do not ever underestimate your power. Seek God with all your heart, and if you do, you will find him. Call upon him, and he will show you great and mighty things. Love you guys.